call.
I show Randy Sneed, I show Julie Stoffer, I show George Knoll, Justin Johnson, Suzanne Umbaugh, attorney Derek Jones, and clerk treasurer Lisa Mullaney. Let's stand and do the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Minutes for July 19, 2017, regular session. Any additional corrections?
I make a motion to accept the minutes.
Second.
Got a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Citizens input. I'm gonna put this under new business. Oh, you got something else? You wanna do it now? Go ahead. You're all rared up, so let's go ahead and do it.
No, I gave a handout to the council, and the library has gone ahead, and if you just hold up the glasses, there's a major eclipse, solar eclipse, on August 21st, and it's a really, it's a big deal in the world of astronomy. We're the only continent that's going to be able to view this eclipse, and this is like a long, long time coming. And we have gone ahead and ordered and gotten in 1,000 pairs of these viewing glasses. We will not see the total eclipse here. Indianapolis will be about a 91% of total eclipse. We'll probably be more like 88-85%. So that means that the sun is not going to ever be totally eclipsed here, and there will be a rim that is going to be visible. This is going to occur around 2:30, 2:35 in the afternoon on that Monday. And our thing was, this is very dangerous for kids or anybody to be looking at an eclipse without these, kind of like a 3D glass, and they are certified by OSI or somebody that certifies these as being safe to use. So we wanted to be able to give one to every student at the school, as well as the staff, support people, whoever would be at the school at that point in time, because this is actually going to be going on when they are released from school. And I know there's a little discussion going on whether this remains a regular school day, maybe an E-day, and that decision, it was just in discussion today. We just kind of threw that out. So I don't know that that's even a possibility, but it would be very dangerous for it. I think the younger the child, the more dangerous it will be, because the less they're going to understand about how dangerous, and oh, I can just sneak a peek. These are only good to look at for 3 minutes, and then you need to look away, even with the glasses. So, I mean, it is considered a very possible. So our cost for this is $320, and so I, for various reasons, I haven't gotten out to other groups. I'm going to go to Lions Group, I'm going to go to our friends group, and probably the old Gold Club and the town, see if they will help us with the expenses. Like I said, the expenses ended up being about $320, and we bought them off of Amazon. And,
yes, it's going to go out too. I mean, you have
yes, that would give to all this the kids at school. So,
what kind of expenses is this stuff that you have?
Well, we haven't really, I suppose, ink, and I didn't figure that into the expense, and I don't know whether we're going to print them or if the school's going to print them, somebody will print them, so that the kids get those and the parents will have that. And if they decide to do an E-day and not have actually an in-session school, we still want them to go home with the kids so that they have that. And then we're going to put a program on August 15th at the library. We have the president of the Warsaw Astronomical Society, and he's going to come and speak to the issue of what it is. And people who attend that at the library will get a pair of glasses. And then we might have 250 pairs, I think, not spoken for. And then our patrons, we may sell those for either 50 cents or a dollar. And that would help us cover some expenses. So if people are willing and can throw in $50, that would be helpful if But it's a community event. That's the only reason I really came to the council, is that it is for a community event. So.
When will they be handed out? On Friday?
I don't, the thing of it is they should not get scratched or beat up or played with.
Right.
So we'd like to pack it for each teacher. It depends what happens as far as.
The E-Day?
Yeah, the E-Day, or if it's going to be a regular school day. If it's a regular school day, it'll probably be that day.
That day.
But if it's a E-Day.
The only issue with that is the parents won't have access to that pamphlet.
Well, we could send that out.
Okay.
Okay.
That, you know, we haven't talked in details.
I'm just saying.
The two principals for me.
Is that it then?
Yes, but I did want to compliment Jamie wherever he is. He's worked very diligently trying to figure out why our megawatts are.
You're not a megawatt yet.
For some reason, our electric bill has gone crazy and we can't figure out why, but we're working on it.
Maybe it's the kids outside using free Wi-Fi.
That would be wishful thinking, but.
All right, thank you, Jamie. Go ahead.
I'd like to make a motion that the town give the Argus Library a total of $320 to cover the cost of all of this.
Second.
Got a motion and a second to cover the cost of all this. For the 3D, for the solar viewing glasses?
Yeah.
The solar eclipse viewing glasses, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries.
Thank you very much. It's very generous of them.
I'll see if you get extra money.
I would love anyone else. Maybe to put on the electric bill.
Sure. Turn on more.
All right, any other citizens input? Yes, Mark?
Several things. Number one, I think to help with the paper, when the citizens give input, they should probably state their name.
Okay.
It'd be helpful. We do that in most consoles, so I think that would be helpful. Mark Gumbel. First thing, my wife's birthday is today. Suzanne Gumbel is.
How
are you?
A year younger? Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
She's 2 years younger than I am, if that helps. Okay. Council members, on the 16th, we have a economic development retreat at 1:30 at Swan Lake. All elected officials in the county are invited to this, so anyone that can make that, fine. The last thing is, we had a police commission meeting. One of the things we talked about was code enforcement. And I didn't bring this up in the meeting, Dustin, but I think one of the things the council needs to consider is upping the amount we pay for code enforcement. Council pays police department $5,000 a year for code enforcement. We started that in 2007, and it's never been changed. So that's 10 years, and it's never been increased. The one thing that I think has been increased is the amount of code enforcement needed. So I would recommend the council take under consideration, maybe talking to Corey or police commission or something about maybe increasing what we're paying for code enforcement. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mark. Any more citizens input? Move on. Old business, attorney report.
You guys, I'll keep it short and sweet tonight. Only one thing to tell you on the 405 South Michigan Street, that letter went out just yesterday. And basically just kind of provided a highlight of the things that Chuck had in his report that he was here for last time. Told Randy and Cindy Drudge are the property owners and asked that they get in touch with Chuck DeWitt. I'll obviously keep this on my radar. I'll let you know at the next meeting whether or not there's been any contact, if I've heard from Chuck, but I guess I wouldn't let it go past the first meeting in September before we decide what steps we're going to take next. I think 30 days is pretty appropriate to allow them some time to get in touch with Chuck and decide what they want to do with anything, but let me know that the letter's been sent and I'll keep this on the radar and keep you updated.
On that, Jamie, I saw somebody down there today, had a vest on and everything, and they were, do you know anything about?
No.
Okay. So, do you know anything about it either, Derek?
I don't, and I doubt that my letter would have reached them today.
Well, Nipso was going around town checking for gas.
Maybe that's who it was. It was just somebody, and they were on that property, and I didn't know Chuck had somebody down there checking things out or what.
I don't know that Chuck has. I don't know anything about it.
Okay.
That's all I have.
I move to accept the attorney's report.
Second.
Did a motion and second to accept the attorney report. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Board openings. It's not changed. We have Marshall County Tourism and we have a plan commission. If you're interested, submit a letter of interest to the senior lady clerk treasurer. Other old business, utility superintendent.
I move that we make Jamie the utility superintendent at the appropriate rate and include the overtime.
I second.
Got a motion and a second to make Jamie utility superintendent at the appropriate rate, including the overtime. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Next up, this don't have to do with Jamie, right?
No.
Okay, next up is the assistant utility superintendent.
I make a motion that we appoint Doug Middleton as assistant superintendent and the pay would be according to the town pay ordinances.
I second.
Got a motion and a second to appoint Doug Middleton to assistant superintendent and his pay would be according to the town salary ordinances. Any further discussion?
You willing to accept that, Doug?
Yeah. Jamie and I have screwed up pretty good, so.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Next up is new lineman.
I make a motion to let Jamie hire a new lineman.
I'll second that.
Got a motion and a second to let Jamie hire a new lineman. Any further discussion?
Yes.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Any other old business? Now we're going to new business. Community Center Fairgrounds. Suzanne's going to present this.
Rob Hurford, who's president of the Fair Board, contacted me last week. They are applying for a grant through OCRA for a community center at the fairgrounds, and he was wanting the town's support. They would like a letter, so I have a letter prepared for the council members if they choose to sign it. It just says, as town council members of Argus, we would like to express our support for a community center at the Marshall County Fairgrounds located in Argus. We feel this would be an asset to the community as well as to the fair. Many within our community have expressed a wish for such a facility, so we are excited for this possibility. We feel such a facility would be well used by Argus and the surrounding communities. If there's any way in which you may help to facilitate this project, please let us know. Sincerely, town council members. So they are applying for a grant and would like our support.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Great. Yeah.
No problem.
Do we need a motion? Do we need a motion? No, I don't think.
I don't think we do.
It says no letter, you do it, don't
you? I make a motion.
It's just
never. Yeah, we'll just sign it.
We'll just sign. Just okay. Sign this.
She's got it already.
You got a form. Sign these individually, or
no.
You just want to sign one?
We have one letter.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Goofy question.
Thank you, Suzanne.
Goofy question. If we decide to go, is this putting us on any liability with OCRA as a grant?
I don't see how it would.
Okay. Because I know we can. We're only allowed one OCRA grant. At a time, I mean, like the town would go for something.
This is just a support.
Yeah, the town's not applying for the grant.
We're just supporting.
It's Marshall County Fairgrounds.
Yeah, I'm just saying, we're supporting.
Gotcha.
It's Marshall County Fairgrounds.
All right. Next up on new business is engineering for the shovel.
Jamie, you want to get in on this?
It's for the engineering for the water and sewer out front of the Shell building, so.
Up to that.
I'll move to go ahead and let Jamie start the process with engineering.
Right, get an engineering company to come in and, a second.
A motion is second to allow Jamie to start the process, get an engineering company to come in for the Shell building. It'll be for the utilities for the Shell building. Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Any other new business? Next up, claims, 858 through 912.
The total docket for August 2nd is $351,409.80. The top five claims are as follows. Number one is IMPA at $182,236.68. Number two is payroll number 15 at $35,928.25. Number three is Capstone Insurance at $18,406. Number four is Anthem at $16,825.12. And number five is Republic Services at $12,113.44. For a total of $265,509.49, which represents 76% of the total docket.
I make a motion to accept the claim docket.
It doesn't work.
If you turn it, it keeps turning.
Yeah.
It's like just.
You have to open it in a second document and it'll come straight up. I just think problem is school dockets.
You gotta be enjoying it.
And the computer guy went.
Do we look like them little bobbleheads?
You do.
This is your comedy hour.
So we got a motion, did I hear a second?
Second.
Got a motion and a second to accept the claims. 858 through 912, any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. And motion to adjourn.
I make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Got a motion and a second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.